Hey everybody, RPG here. Today I'm going to show you guys how to change the boot order on your HP Pavilion Gaming PC. So you'd be doing this if, for example, you went and installed an additional SSD or hard drive onto your PC and you want to boot to that as opposed to the stock hard drive that came with it. So in this case, for this video, I have my HP Pavilion Gaming PC. It has a hard drive on it with Windows 10. That's what it boots to every time I turn it on. But I've gone and installed a 4TB SSD from Samsung that has Bodicera on it so I can get into all my favorite retro video games. So I want to change it from the default hard drive, which has Windows 10 on it, over to the Bodicera SSD. So every time I turn on my PC, Bodicera boots up as opposed to Windows 10. So I'm going to show you exactly what you need to do. It's really a super easy process. And once you get through it the first time and learn what the exact process is, it'll only take you a few seconds to do, so you can actually have dual purpose to your PC and be able to use it as a regular PC as well as a emulation gaming PC. So before we get started here, first thing we need to do is we need to power on our gaming PC, and then we need to hit F10 on our keyboard multiple times as soon as we hit that power button. So you don't have to go crazy banging on the keyboard or anything like that. Just go ahead and hit it maybe 10 times. It's not going to do any damage hitting it multiple times, but 10 times just to be safe, because if you don't hit it as soon as you power it on, it'll already start the booting process and you'll boot right into Windows 10. You don't want to do that, because then you have to go and shut down and restart your computer all over again. Just tap that F10 button, like I said, maybe 10 times or so, and you're going to boot right into the BIOS settings utility tool. All right, so once we've powered on our PC and we've hit F10 on our keyboard to open up our BIOS setup utility here, and again, different PCs and PC brands may have a different function button that you need to hit, so you just have to figure out what your particular PC's requirements are to actually open up this menu here. And this menu may actually be labeled differently depending on what brand or PC you're using. It might just be BIOS setup settings or something to that effect. In this case, with this HP Pavilion Gaming PC, it's called BIOS setup utility. Regardless of what PC or PC brand you're using though, you're going to have pretty much the same functions and features. They just may be set up and laid out differently or even labeled differently. But for the most part, all PCs have the same functions and features within. So where we want to go from here is we want to go over to boot options, because we want to go in and we want to change our boot order. So we're going to go over with our right arrow key, navigate over to boot options. And we want to go into what's already highlighted here by default, and that's OS Boot Manager. So this is where we can go in and make those changes to our boot order. So we're going to scroll down to it if we aren't already highlighted onto it, and just hit enter. That's going to open up our OS Boot Manager. So here, if you don't have an SSD or additional SSD or additional hard drive installed on your PC and you only have the hard drive that came with it, you're only going to have one option here, because you're not going to have dual options that you can switch between. You're only going to have that one hard drive. So in this case, I have this Samsung SSD, which is a 4TB SSD with Bodicera on it, and I'm able to actually play all of my favorite retro video game collections through Bodicera. So that's what I have here. That's that second option down. So what this means, the way that it's laid out right now, is your first option on your list here is going to be what your computer boots to every single time that you power it on. So in this case, Windows Boot Manager is highlighted, and what Windows Boot Manager really is it's the default hard drive that was installed on this PC, and it happens to have Windows 10 on it. So if I were to power on my PC and not hit F10 as I did here in this video, it would boot up to Windows 10. What I want to do is I want to change it so when I boot up my PC, it automatically boots to Bodicera and I can jump right into my retro video games and different collections on here. So what I need to do is I need to swap these out. I need to have this UEFI OS, which is in parentheses Samsung SSD 8070 QVO 4TB. I need to have that listed first. So if we look in the background there on that right column, it actually gives us instructions, but the instructions are super vague and really not self-explanatory. So what it says there under item specific help is up and down arrow keys select a device. F5 and F6 keys move the device down or up. The boot capability will be disabled if the device is marked with an exclamation mark. So that doesn't really mean a whole lot to me, and I'm pretty savvy with computers. But what it translates to is
you need to hit F5 or F6 to swap out your boot orders. So, as I've mentioned, Windows Boot Manager is the highlighted option here. So we're going to be booting to Windows 10. We want to switch it to this one right here. So if we're highlighting the top one, we need to hit F5. It's going to swap them. If we were highlighting the bottom one, we have to hit F6. So again, not super self-explanatory from the description that they give you and instructions over there in the corner, but right now I have the Windows back at the top, so I'm going to hit F5. It swaps it. So now my Samsung SSD is the option at the top. So that means that when I reboot my system and every time after I boot my computer up, it's going to automatically boot up to Bata Sara, and I'm going to be able to play all my retro video games. So right below here, you'll notice the line that says press F10 to save and escape to cancel. That just means that we want to hit F10, which I'm going to do right now on our keyboard, and that's going to save this. So if we were to jump right back in here just to confirm that everything's saved the way we want it to, I'll hit enter again, and you'll notice now that that Samsung SSD is the option at the top. So we know that everything's good there. I'm gonna hit escape since I don't need to make any changes. But now what I wanna do is show you one last thing we need to change. And you don't always have to change this, but if you're using Bata Sara and most platforms for emulation, you do wanna make this change. And you need to go up here to where it says secure boot. And you notice that it says right now enabled. And if we jump over to the right, where it gives us our description of each of these functions, it says, when secure boot is enabled, BIOS performs cryptographic check during boot up for the integrity of the software image. It prevents unauthorized or maliciously modified software from running. So basically, it's just a safety thing. It's kind of protecting your system and not trusting most software on here. So we want to make this disabled. So all we have to do is just highlight it like it is right now, hit enter, go up with our arrow key to disabled, and hit enter again. That swaps it out and changes it to disabled now. So that means that our computer is no longer going to be making decisions for us. It's going to let us actually boot to whatever we want here. So again, we already changed the boot order. That was just like the safety net that the system puts into effect. So what we need to do now is just exit out of here. So we'll go with our right arrow key to exit, and we're going to select that first option, which says save changes and exit. So we'll hit enter. It's going to give us a little confirmation here, just verifying that we do in fact want to save these changes and exit. So what we're going to do is we're going to hit yes. As soon as we hit yes, our computer is going to reboot, and it's going to boot up to whatever we've selected as the boot order that we want to go into. So in this case, again, Samsung 4TB SSD running Bata Sara. So let's go ahead and confirm this and boot up our system. So sometimes when you do this for the first time, you might get a operating system boot mode change confirmation like this. So it just says a change to the operating system secure boot mode is pending. Please enter the passcode displayed below to complete the change. If you did not initiate the request, press the escape key to continue without accepting the pending change. So it's going to tell us here a code that we need to hit along with enter to complete the change, or escape if we want to disregard what we've put into effect. It's just, again, another little safety net here that the system puts into effect. So I'm going to go ahead and hit that code there, which in this case is the 0369, and then enter. All right, so you can see just like that, I'm able to now boot up to Bata Sara, and I have full access to all of my favorite retro video game collections. So now every time that I hit the power button on my gaming PC, I'm gonna boot right into Bata Sara. And if I ever wanna change it back, so let's say, you know, I wanna use this PC for dual purpose, I wanna use it as a regular PC running Windows 10, as well as a gaming PC, then anytime I wanna swap it out and switch over to Windows 10, I would just do the exact same thing we just did, go in and hit F10 to open up your utility, and then just swap out the boot order, save it, and reboot your system, and you'll be into Windows 10.
All right, guys, so you can see from this video, super easy process here. Obviously, this takes a little bit longer for me to walk you guys through the process, but from here on out, you'll be able to do this and swap out your boot order in just a matter of seconds, really. So Doesn't get any easier than this. So if you have any questions or anything like that, feel free to hit me up in the comment section below or reach out to me directly. Always happy to help any way I possibly can. That's gonna do it for this video. If you enjoyed it, you found it helpful, smash the like button for me. Be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel here. We do a ton of different videos based around retro gaming. We do product reviews, gameplay demos, tutorials like this one. And then of course we've got the Forgotten Favorites YouTube series, which comes out every single Monday and Thursday evening. So a lot of great stuff on here, a lot of great retro gaming content. So definitely subscribe if you haven't already. And then of course, check us out online on our website, www.retropieguy.com. Thanks for watching.